car update for today. I went out at lunchtime and took the flywheel and crankshaft and clutch to be balanced. Hopefully that'll only take a few weeks. They seemed really busy, but he did suggest refacing the inside of the flywheel where the friction plate rides, just to give that a nice smooth surface. It was a little bit rust pitted, so he's going to take the minimum amount off that and reduce the height of the cover, or the sides rather, so the cover sits in the same place. But that should be pretty easy to do for them. And I was finally able to get some bits of plywood and do something I've been meaning to do for a long, long time, which is get some racks up for long pieces of steel and wood and aluminium and bits and pieces like that. So basically I moved these from my old house, these brackets, and because it's a metal shed, I needed something to screw them to. So I've just mounted four pieces of plywood to the metal cross pieces and then bolted the brackets to those. So that's all looking a lot cleaner now. It's been something that's been bugging me for a long, long time. Tonight I've been working on just little jobs again. There's all sorts of fiddly little bits and pieces. I've been cleaning up more of the brake parts, and I found the best two of the little cams, the little levers. The holes were all worn out, so I welded those up and re-drilled them. So they should be good now. The rest of the parts have just been cleaned up. They need a paint at some point. And I just need four of these spring units. I was also cleaning up the bolts. So they'll just get cleaned up over the next few days. And I've already got some parts ordered, new springs, other various little bits and pieces that I need. They do have these little washers in the end, which are all covered in grease. So I'll have to pick out the best four of those that aren't all worn out. And I also started stripping down the two starter motors that I've got that are the same. This one is completely missing its brushes. The end caps and various bits and pieces are sitting in the degreaser. This one is still attached. The brushes on these are copper, I think, or some sort of bronze or something like that. They're not carbon anyway, and they're actually screwed to the little spring things. These are the armatures. This came out of this one. This one is fairly rusty, and you can see it hasn't had a cover on it, and it's all pretty manky. The inside of this is a little bit rusty and a little bit grubby. I haven't checked the field coils yet to see if they conduct. This was the other one, the one that had the brushes. This one was a bit cleaner. I've just cleaned it with a Scotch-Brite. But this one's been machined down quite a lot, or worn down quite a lot. It's about a millimeter and a half, a smaller diameter than this one. You can almost even see it. You just sort of compare the two and look at the thickness of the copper brushes. So I need to check these and see if these are still okay. This one looks like it's missing its string, and you can see how it's rusted. So what I'm hoping is I can rebuild one good one out of these two slightly dodgy ones. One of the things on this one, I did try powering it up and it didn't work at all. And the reason is this field winding here is totally disconnected. It looks like somebody's put a bolt in there and tried to solder that onto the end of it. I'm not sure that would ever work. There's a lot of current that goes through these, and if they heat up, that solder would just melt. That was a terrible joint in there anyway. This one looks original, and it looks more like it's sort of pinned through somehow. I'm not sure exactly how that works, but if the field coils in this one are good and I can clean the rust off it, this is probably the one to use. It's just going to take a little bit more measuring and cleaning up before I know what I can do. Tonight has been more cleaning up of brake parts and starter motor. So I've been sorting through the brake parts, trying to figure out which bits I was going to use. These are the front levers. These are all the rear brake levers. various tubes, the little D things that I welded up and then re-drilled. And I've been looking at the screws that go into the tubes. So this is what holds the spring inside the tube. So the spring's inside here. This has a washer on the end, which is what's in the ultrasonic cleaner at the moment. And there are these little sort of rod end type things that this screws into. The neat thing about these is these screws are slotted on the end. And I believe the reason they do that is so that when you have the little D-ring inside there, and then you've got the clevis pin through it, this threads through far enough that that little slot is holding the little D-ring. And what that will do is that'll stop this being able to turn, so it can't ever come undone. I thought that was quite neat once I figured out that's what it was for. The problem is I've got quite good bolts, but most of them end up broken. And I think that's because they rust, because they're exposed to the elements, and then when you undo them, they just break off. So I need four, and I think I have three and a bit, or else there's this one, which is complete on that end, but the end on the screw isn't very good. The rest of them are broken, and what I'm wondering is if modern Loctite is enough to actually hold these in place. Or the other thing I could do is use the two good ones on the end and just slot these ones a little bit extra. What that would mean is the spring will have a tiny little bit more preload on it, but I think that should be fine. I should have a die somewhere so I could tap the thread a bit further down. The threads aren't very consistent anyway, because you can see this one's broken off, but it was threaded much further down already. So I think I should just be able to reslot those, and that little extra bit of compression on the spring isn't going to matter too much, hopefully. These are available new, but I'm just being cheap because they're about £7 or £8 each. So those are all right. I'll pick a good set of four of these where the holes aren't too worn out. You can see that one's either been drilled out or it's just worn out. So that's the brake components. One thing I do need to do is replace this pulley wheel. I'm not sure if these are available new. I haven't seen them. If I had a decent enough lump of brass, I could machine one. This one is pretty beaten up. It looks like somebody's been hammering on it. I do have various other brake pulleys, but I believe they are the same size as the ones on the compensating mechanism, so they're not correct. They're going to be too small. So that is something I need to replace as well. This is the one that goes on the back, held in this little clamp thing. And then the starter motors. So I've completely stripped them down, and I've basically taken the best bits from the two that I had that were the same and cleaned those up, and I'm going to use those. Electrically, there isn't as much testing you can do as you can do on the dynamo, because these windings are very fat, so it's very low resistance. So all I could check was basically there's resistance, or very low resistance, from one of the terminals to this, which is the positive terminal, and then from the other one to the earth terminal here. And then make sure there are no shorts between these and the case, which there aren't. And similar on this, I just checked that there was conductivity between each of the segments, and there was no conductivity to the body, so it's not shorting out. I gave these a good clean in some degreaser, and then a really good soak in just clean water. And then I actually put these in my little toaster oven for quite a while at about 80 or 90 degrees C just to dry them out. This is still pretty warm. These are various spaces, which hopefully I can remember where they go. I've picked the best of the end caps, and these are the little things that go right on the very end. This one seems very coppery for some reason. I'm not sure why that would be like that, if it's actually been copper plated or if it's because of copper that's come off the commutator, worn off. This one I did have to skim very, very lightly in the lathe. It had kind of a little indentation on it where I think it's where the brush has been sitting. So I just lightly skimmed it, minimal amount, and then used a little bit of scotch, the scotch cleaning pad on that, just to polish it up. One of the springs had fractured, so that's not going to be much good to me. The other one seems okay at the moment. These are available new, but I think this one, if it hasn't broken now, hopefully it'll be okay for a bit longer. And I'll pick the best of the gears and the little, not sure what you would call that. Is it a Bendix? Is that bit the Bendix? I'm not sure. And these are the brushes. I've only got one set of the brushes, and these are much harder than carbon brushes. So they have to take a lot more current. This will be drawing probably hundreds of amps very briefly while it's spinning up. So probably the job for tomorrow, over the weekend, will be putting this back together and seeing if it works again. It's all too hot at the moment. I'll clean up all the little screws and bits and pieces, as well as the band on the outside. But there isn't really much to these. I think I've got far more chance of getting one of these to work than I had with the dynamo, so hopefully that means I'll have a working one by the end of it. And I think that was it. I still haven't really done much else on the chassis at the moment. So I think for today, that's all.